Thanks, Preeti. And I want to just tell our viewers that I finally cracked the mystery of this Aapka Cola and the Aapka Lemon. The drink and fight for right. You know, can I just get my camera person to zoom in and show you? Drink and fight for right. These, of course, being handed out to people as they come in. And I was wondering who's doing that. So now we have the answer to that question. This comes from SPS Prince Beverages. Aapke liye Aapka Cola. Free, free, free. Drink and fight for right. So this is interesting. Ab badle ki Delhi 5 saal Kejriwal. So marketing opportunity also here for SBS Prince Beverages. The best thing, of course, to do would be to have one of these beverages while watching the World Cup of cricket, which unfortunately we're not being able to do with the New Zealand and Sri Lanka game going really well. But maybe tomorrow when the India-Pakistan match takes place. Earlier, remember, this was supposed to happen on the 15th of February, which was clashing with the India-Pakistan match. They advanced it by a day so that it didn't clash. I want to now put out the first poster of Arvind Kejriwal without his muffler. Now, people have really been why he has that muffler on, even though it's not. I'm just wearing a shirt and a sleeveless jacket. It's not cold. But despite that, Kejriwal's been insisting on putting that muffler on. Now, Ankit Tyagi, for the first time, the muffler's gone. So, the muffler man now finally without his muffler, and frankly, it's about time.
Absolutely, Rahul. Summers are now just right on the corner, so I'm sure a muffler would have been very uncomfortable for Arvind Kejriwal. And in the new poster that has been released, this is very significantly thanking people, of course. And Rahul, if you look at that, it's without the cap and it's with a Nehru jacket. So a very new look of Arvind Kejriwal. The joke doing rounds is that he met the Prime Minister and probably picked up some style tips from there with that Nehru jacket that Arvind Kejriwal is donning in the new poster. So that's a new look poster of Delhi's CM. The summers have come, and this is what they have released today. All across the streets of Delhi, thanking people for this historic feat that Aam Aadmi Party has been able to achieve. And Arvind Kejriwal smiling in his blue shirt and a Nehru jacket. You know, just as I told you, people, a lot of people calling it the style tips being given there by Prime Minister, probably that he's adorning right now.
Well, Ankit, the Prime Minister's sartorial sense has landed him in a lot of trouble with that fancy suit with his name monogrammed on it becoming an election issue. So I don't think Arvind Kejriwal needs to take fashion tips from the Prime Minister just yet. But tell me, why did he keep that muffler on? What was the tactical thought behind that muffler? Because for the several days that he's kept that muffler on, it's been quite hot, frankly, to even have had a sweater. At that time, to have had that muffler on must have been miserable inside his head. What? Is it because he's ill? Is it because he thinks it's a marketing ploy? Is it because he's trying to position himself as the social media nomenclature of the muffler man? What is it that he was pushing for, Ankit?
You know, Rahul, this whole muffler thing started last election. Arvind Kejriwal was not well. He was keeping bad health, and that is how the muffler came in. And it was made a joke by opponents. What the Aam Aadmi Party very interestingly and very smartly did this time with Narendra Modi using the broom for Swachh Bharat campaign, they started a muffler man campaign, making him a superhero and calling it the muffler man is back when they started their campaign on the social media for Delhi election somewhere way back in October. And since then, Arvind Kejriwal has made sure that the muffler becomes a symbol, that becomes his identity as a common man who is just out there on the road. And he has used it very smartly. It has stuck to him, and this is something that every winter, no matter what you see, Arvind Kejriwal in that sweater and the muffler is going to stick. That is something that they are not going to let go of.
Well, it's interesting though that on the day that he takes the oath of office, the muffler is gone and instead he's got the Nehru jacket. And as Aam Aadmi Party volunteers themselves are joking, this happened immediately after his meeting with Prime Minister Modi. We're slipping into a quick break here. Our live coverage from the Ramlila Maidan resumes when we come back on the other side. We leave you with these images. The build-up here at the Ramlila Maidan. Thousands of people flocking in to see Arvind Kejriwal take the oath of office. We return live to Ramlila Maidan on the other side of a quick break. Preeti Chaudhary. Preeti, it's not just the Indian media that's plugged on to the Kejriwal success story. Lots of French, American, British journalists also out here at this dais trying to understand one of the most significant political triumphs in recent Indian history.
Well, it is a media stakeout right at the Ram Leela Maidan, understandably so, because Arvind Kejriwal swearing in hasn't just generated enough intrigue in India but abroad as well. So we're at the media hall right now, and we have these three journalists who've come in from France. Hi, where are you guys from?
From France.
Namaskar. And what brings you here? Why are you here?
The election of the AAP was really impressive. Actually, we were already here 1 year ago.
Right.
And this is a quite important day, because now that the AAP has a full mandate for 5 years.
Right.
And free hands.
So you guys were here last year when he took oath, and you were here, Rak.
Exactly.
Why does it intrigue you guys? Why is Aam Aadmi Party so interested?
Because the political life of India is both young and old. I mean, it's a 60-something year old democracy, and with very historical parties. So this new party, which is supposed to be doing politics in a new way, is doing it in quite a surprising victory. So no.
Is it generating any interest in France, as Arvind Kejriwal, Aam Aadmi Party, is it generating any press at all?
Yeah, definitely, because Kejriwal is a common man from the people, right? So in France it's quite surprising that to see such a career, such a
right.
political career.
All right, so what channel are you guys from? Are you from a news channel or a documentary? What are you guys?
TF1 French TV, it's general channel. It's some French news channel. And some documentaries and some...
Have you guys got an interview with Arvind Kejriwal yet?
No, not yet. But
hopefully, can you help us?
We will try and help you. Thank you so much, and have a good day. Thank you, appreciate it. Well, there you have it—a massive media stakeout there. These three young gentlemen are from France, tracking the event. They were here 1 year back. They are here the second time over. Reporting with camera person Kripal Preeti Chaudhary for headlines today.
Interesting how this is a story that's got newsrooms excited, not just across India, but across the world. We're heading into a quick break. We return live to the Ram Leela Maidan on the other side. Crowds filling in fast, preparations on in a short while from now. Arvind will leave East Kaushambi residence to be here at the Ram Leela Maidan. And we've got eyes and ears on the ground. We'll return live on the other side of these messages. This is Arvind Kejriwal's residence. This is Sivani village in Haryana. Three chief ministers from this place, but this is the place where Arvind Kejriwal belongs. He was born in this particular small room. We'll try and show it to you. It's a small room out here. It's dark and dingy, but he was born here. He belongs to humble belongings, and he's very proud of his family. Now, tell us, how many times Arvind Kejriwal come here to his house, and how are they welcomed? And now, what is the feeling when he becomes the Prime Minister again?
We are so happy when we come here. It's a happy thing. We meet each other, and it's a Ram Ram Sham Sham. तो अच्छा लगता है। हमें भी अभी तक दिल्ली का मुख्यमंत्री बन गया, और हमें अभी तक ये वो याद कर रहे हैं कि तो हमें तो खुशी होती है। हम तो कहते हैं, हमने तो उनको दिल्ली में बधाई भी दी है।
ओके, लेट्स ट्राई एंड शो यू मोर फैमिली मेंबर्स आउट हियर क्विकली कमिंग आउट ऑफ दिस प्लेस। दिस इज द फर्स्ट फ्लोर, दिस इज द स्मॉल रेजिडेंस, द फैमिली यूज टू स्टे हियर। लेट्स सी व्हाट अदर पीपल हैव टू से। यू आर अ कजन, आप ये बताइए किस तरह से खुशी है और क्या तैयारियां हैं?
मैं बहुत खुशी है।
Ram Leela Maidan all spruced up, and people now getting to the Ram Leela Maidan in large numbers to attend Arvind Kejriwal's swearing-in ceremony. And as Headlines Today's managing editor Rahul Kamal was just telling us, there's also Aam Aadmi Cola and Aam Aadmi Lemon. Aapka Cola, Aapka Lemon. Rahul, all the flavors of Ram Leela Maidan, and this is one historic Maidan where Arvind Kejriwal has had a tryst with history even before.
Oh, absolutely. And I've got the Aam Aadmi ka expert, Dr. Ashok Lahiri, now joining us. He just had some very interesting observations coming in. Sir, you were able to walk all the way in. What did you pick up about the mood and the atmosphere here at the Ram Leela Maidan?
Rahul, I have been to Ram Leela Maidan many times. I remember Jayaprakash Narayan's meeting.
You were here that time?
I was here at that time. I was born a long time ago. What I find, it's a popular outburst of enthusiasm. You know, politics sometimes becomes like a love affair. You can't explain why you are here, but you are here.
And today is Valentine's Day.
Valentine's Day as well. And I must tell you as an aside, there are some very popular solutions. For example, one gentleman is holding a placard which says, if you find any Sarkari Karamchari, Bhrashtachar, any corrupt government official, for seven generations no one should get a job in this family.
How do you enjoy that?
And any politician found to be corrupt, forever his family should be barred from joining politics. Now, these are not practical solutions, but still, it's a symptom that they're very unhappy with the current state of affairs.
Okay, stay with me. I want to show our viewers the atmosphere here at the Ram Leela Maidan this morning, with thousands of people holding the tricolor, holding Aam Aadmi Party flags, all of them wearing the caps of the Aam Aadmi Party, coming in, singing and dancing. They're all very excited this morning. Do you sense that there is greater realism here, Dr. Lahiri? The last time there was more romance in the air, this time there's greater realism and a sense that you've got the mandate you wanted, now must begin the business end of getting things done.
Absolutely. In fact, Mr. Kejriwal, to be fair, one thing that he has admitted, that one of the greatest mistakes was resigning after 49 days. He said, abhi wo nahi karenge, which is a very good sign. We have given him the mandate. I'm a Haryanvi. Delhiites have given him the mandate. He has to run Delhi.
Do you think he'll be out on a dharna soon? What's your gap? What's your prediction? 1 week, 1 month, 1 year, 6 months? How many months before the first dharna?
I hope there are no dharnas. But normally in a federal system, there will be, and particularly given that Delhi is a peculiar, it's a national capital territory. Delhi belongs to all of India, not only Delhiites like you. So there will be strains between Raisina Hill and old secretariat. That is there many times, unless it's the same party. You will find there is unhappiness on both sides.
Okay. Let me show our viewers the podium where the swearing-in will take place in a short while from now. That's where the preparations are currently on, and that's where Arvind Kejriwal will be, where he'll be taking the oath of office. I want to go across to my colleague Rishika Barua. She's giving us an update on the preparations right outside the Ram Leela Maidan, and the colour and the festivity that can be seen all across this historic town square. Here's Rishika Barua with the latest.
While most of the Aam Aadmi Party supporters today don, that characteristic white Gandhi topi, here is somebody who's dressed very differently. पहले तो आप अपना नाम बताइए कहाँ से हैं?
मैं गोपाल प्रधान से हूँ, नाम मेरा उदयवीर है।
अच्छा, और ये आप क्या मोर बने हुए हैं और इतने सारे केजरीवाल आपने लगाए हुए हैं, क्या कर रहे हैं आप?
ये केजरी मोर बने हैं सर, मैडम हम।
अच्छा, ये क्या स्पेशल है ये?
स्पेशल यही है कि ये मुझे शपथ ग्रहण में पहनना था ये आज।
अच्छा
जी हाँ।
क्यों?
ये दिल से उम्मीद थी केजरीवाल सीएम बनेंगे और मैंने इसमें 10 दिन से मेहनत करी है।
10 दिन से आप ये बना रहे हैं?
हाँ।
क्या 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 किया है आपने इसको बनाने में, जरा ऊपर से नीचे तक पूरा समझाइए।
ये इसमें 2000 तिल्लियां है, 4000 फोटो है और 75 बैच है, ये बाकी ये लटकन भी है।
अच्छा, और अब आप मतलब आप यहीं खड़े रहेंगे कि कुछ एक्शन भी होगा, कुछ मोर नाचेंगे भी और कुछ मतलब कुछ करके भी दिखाएंगे?
मोर नाचेगा भी।
तो दिखाइए
That was Rishika Barua reporting for us. I want to focus with Dr. Lahiri on something very interesting that he's done for India Today magazine. He's actually added up all the costs of the promises that Arvind Kejriwal has made and compared this with the Delhi budget to get a sense of whether or not these promises can be fulfilled, and ask that important question, where is the rest of the money coming from? So from what I've understood, you've said that the total cost of his promises is 69,000 crores over 5 years. The Delhi budget is only 13,000 crores.
No, Delhi budget is, it's about, you're right.
So where does the rest of the 56 odd thousand crores come from? Where does Kejriwal get this money from?
No, there has to be expenditure restructuring or some revenue mobilization.
But how much can he garner even if he does what he says in the manifesto? He actually wants to reduce VAT, right?
I haven't. The VAT is already figured in. Revenue foregone is like an expenditure, so that's already there.
So he needs 56,000 crores extra. He's thinking Santa Claus Modi will come and give it to him?
So that's very difficult because you can't give it to one state and not to the others. But I haven't done the calculation whether it's possible to garnered these resources or to get it somewhere from somewhere in terms of public-private partnership. All I have said is that this is the number that I'm getting. These are my assumptions. If anyone thinks that I have committed a mistake, I'm most open to suggestions.
No, but this is very important. Let me just try and put it out in the way that I see it. 69,000 crores is the total value of all the promises that Kejriwal has made over 5 years. And the amount of money that he has every year is about 13,000 crores. So the gap is about 56,000 crores over 5 years, which means roughly read about 12,000, 11,000 crores every year extra. Now, unless he's hoping that the BJP opens up the central war chest, gives him this money, it's going to be a big challenge for Kejriwal to fulfill this promise, because you've got all these lakhs of people here, thousands of people, who've got these big expectations, but soon, like they're asking Modi now, they'll ask Kejriwal, where's the free bijli, where's the free pani, where's the free Wi-Fi?
Let me give you an example, okay? Free Wi-Fi you have talked about. Now, is it free Wi-Fi for 5 hours? No.
No, there's no terms and condition. He says free Wi-Fi all the way.
No, but free Wi-Fi you have in Connaught Place. It's only for the first 20 minutes. So Tata Tele Services have given that. For 20 minutes, you give your name, your telephone number, so they get the data. So for 20 minutes, you get it free. After that, you have to buy a card. So that's a clever solution. Similarly, when you look at old age pension, you may think that every old man like me also will get a pension. No. It's only if your salary in income is less than 60,000 rupees per year. So it's a targeted subsidy.
So the devil is always in the details.
Devil is always in the details. So there may be a way. I'm not saying at all that this cannot be done. But this is going to be a challenge.
Okay. I want to go across now to my colleague Smita Sharma. She's with us outside the Ram Leela Maidan, speaking to the people as they come in. Let's try and get a sense of the mood amongst the volunteers, the real Aam Aadmi, who are coming in to attend Kejriwal's swearing in. Smita, take it away.
आम आदमी पार्टी के सारे वॉलंटियर्स जिस जिसकी क्या ड्यूटी है
Delhi witnessed a high voter turnout in these assembly elections and an absolutely decisive mandate. Now, in fact, we are expecting a high turnout in Ram Leela grounds as well. People pouring in not just from Delhi but beyond Delhi, from across other states as well. Aam Aadmi Party volunteers to witness the swearing in ceremony at Ram Leela Maidan. And while police forces, of course, are keeping an eye out on all logistical arrangements, our volunteers too are working around here. Let's try and get a word from this gentleman who has been making announcements.
तीन नंबर गेट से प्रवेश करें।
ये बताइए कि अरेंजमेंट क्या हो रखा है, कौन सी गेट से लोग अंदर जा सकते हैं?
तीन नंबर गेट से महिलाएं, बुजुर्ग और बच्चे जाएंगे। चार, पाँच, छह, सात, आठ नंबर गेट से अन्य लोग प्रवेश करेंगे।
अच्छा
जी।
तो कितना एक्सपेक्ट कर रहे हैं टर्नआउट, कितने आपके वॉलंटियर्स होंगे जो आज काम कर रहे हैं?
3,000 वॉलंटियर हमारे काम पे लगे हुए हैं आज।
3,000 वॉलंटियर्स लगे हुए हैं। कितनी की भीड़ की उम्मीद कर रहे हैं आप?
1.5 लाख और 2 लाख के बीच में आएंगे।
लेकिन उतनी तो है नहीं क्षमता इस ग्राउंड की।
12 LED वगैरह लगा रखी है, वहाँ से लोग देखेंगे
अंदर। अलग अलग जगह?
हाँ, अलग अलग जगह। हाँ, अलग 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 जगह पे। और बाकी लोग बाहर से देखेंगे, जितनी कैपेसिटी अंदर है उतने ही लोग जाएंगे। उसके बाद हमारे वॉलंटियर जो हैं उनको रोक देंगे और बाहर की तरफ ही खड़े रहेंगे लोग।
क्या नाम क्या आपका सर?
मैं गुलशन आनंद
हूँ। और आप कब से जुड़े हुए हैं आप?
मैं अन्ना मूवमेंट से जुड़ा हूँ।
राइट, यू नो, सो दिस इज द वेरी ग्राउंड दैट ऑफ कोर्स प्रोड्यूस दैट अन्ना मूवमेंट। People are being instructed to, of course, use, you know, there are 8 entry gates to Ram Leela Maidan. People are being used to going through all the other gates. There is a specific entry gate for media, for security reasons. But women, children and elderly people are being asked to enter through gate number 3. So if you are coming in to Ram Leela Maidan, try and come in advance so that you can avoid some confusion. With Viru Jonas Aluk Bhatnagar in New Delhi, this is Smita Sharma for Headlines Today.
Huge amounts of excitement here at the Ram Leela Maidan, and we of course will continue our coverage from the Maidan. We've got Dr. Lahiri with us in a moment from now. Some Aam Aadmi Party leaders will also be joining us, and in fact some of these faces are so new and so fresh that they weren't even allowed in because the cops didn't know who they were. So I'm just told that Raghav Chadda, who's actually a prominent TV face but mostly on the English stations, wasn't allowed in because the cops couldn't recognize him, and they kind of, you know, at least he had a tough time getting in.
Rahul, this is really Aam Aadmi in the genuine sense of the term. We have seen political parties which are bottom up down. Here this is really bottom up. you can't make out who is who of the Aam Aadmi Party. But the question is, can a political party be run on such spontaneous basis? It will have to have a structure over time.
But is this a spontaneous base according to you? Is this now a very well-oiled political machine? They fought three elections, they've increased their vote share in each election, and in each election they've been able to build a stronger base now.
Yeah, if those three elections were 5 years apart, stretched over 15 years, then you could have said this must be a well-oiled political machine.
Okay, but Rishika Barua is at that place where Raghav Chadha is being given a tough time. Let's now go across to Rishika. Rishika, why is it that these Aam Aadmi Party leaders are not being allowed in there today? At least today, they're the Khas Aadmi. Rishika? Audio problem. Audio. I think we're having some. Okay, we're having some issues with that audio. We'll fix that. We'll return live to the Ram Leela Maidan, where it's building up to Arvind.